Hello everyone, I'm Smita, I blog at Smiling Colors, and as promised, I have a bonus video this week showing you how to print your own sentiments for your handmade cards. In my last video, I created this set of note cards, but I didn't have a stamp set for this particular sentiment. And so I decided to print them off of my computer, and I will walk you through the steps today. I'm using Adobe Photoshop CS6 here, and I'm going to start by creating a new file. My card is going to be 4.25 inches wide and 5.5 inches tall. That's a standard A2 card. For print quality, you always want to maintain at least 300 dpi resolution. And I'm going to go ahead and name this file here as card front. So now we have a rectangle that is the exact size of the card I'm going to be printing. I want to add a sentiment in the center here. So I'm going to click on the type tool and then click to bring the cursor, then type in my words. This is going to be a thank you card for bridesmaids. Once I'm done typing, I'm going to click on this arrow on the top left corner. That's the move tool. And then I can drag my words around and move them to wherever I want them to be. I'm just eyeballing it here. I don't want this particular sentiment to be in the exact center for today's card, but you can center it easily. Next, I want to reduce the font size a bit. So in the character box, I just moved the box to the center so you could see it better in the video. I'm choosing a smaller font size right here. Now the fonts you use, you can choose any font you like, and I'm using Avenir font today, and you can change it by clicking into the character box here again and run through a couple of fonts and see which ones you would prefer to use today. There are a lot of handwritten fonts available online, but today I think I'm going to stick with Avenir, and yes, I have a lot of fonts on my computer, don't judge me please. Now you could also change the color of the words if you wanted by clicking on the little color palette box here and choosing a different shade. I'm sticking with black for today. Now it's time to print. Click on File and then Print. A print box should pop up. Mine is a Canon printer and I'm going to click on Print Settings next. You want to go into the paper size. It is usually set at a default US letter size for me, but today we need to create a new paper size. So click on Manage Custom Sizes, and we need to create a new one at 4.25 by 5.5 inches in size. And I keep all of my borders at 0 inches if possible. Then you want to choose your orientation to be vertical or portrait, and then immediately you will see the preview here, and that is exactly what we want to print. So I'm making 4 cards today and I need to make 4 copies of this, and I'm going to hit print next. The video gets really shaky here, but I just wanted to show you now. At your printer, you need to remove your regular paper, that's the regular printer paper you use every day, remove that from the feed and then place your trimmed cardstock here. I'm actually using watercolor paper, which has been trimmed to 4.25 by 5.5 inches here, and it works beautifully. For my printer, I need to move this little blue handle so that the paper sits snug in the middle, and then I need to push the paper all the way in, and I also need to open the paper tray and then click my paper feed into place. And then we just wait for it to print. Voila! We have the sentiment that we needed printed exactly where we wanted it. Now I have 4 of these printed out, and once you have this method figured out, you can basically print out any sentiment you want onto your cards in any color and in any font. Now I take these blank card fronts and I painted flowers around it, and it's a very fun and easy watercoloring technique, and you can click here to go and watch that video. Let me know in the comments below if this video was helpful at all to you. I will try and include more such videos if it interests all of you. Hit subscribe to get updates on my channel, and as always, more details, information and photos can be found on my website smilingcolors.com.